Vlog number 169, Sunday, May 12th, 2024, 7:47 a.m. I don't know how much I'm going to vlog today because it is Mother's Day. I may or may not go to Glacier Park. I turned it to the Thundermans. The plan for this morning is just going to be, I'm just going to sit here. Maybe I'll edit some more of the vlog. I started last night but got distracted when the Northern Lights came. So I only got like 5 minutes done. It's a 50 minute vlog, so it's gonna take a really long time. I don't want these clips to be too long because I don't want to run out of storage space, as I've been saying for the past 2 months. So I'm just gonna sit here, watch the Thundermans, and probably update you whenever I do something else. I don't know.
It's the Kel Mitchell episode. I absolutely love Kel Mitchell. Was on Pictionary the last day I left from Missoula. Of course, he was on Game Shakers. There he is, Kel Mitchell.
Right, it's 9 o'clock. I was just watching Thundermans for the past like hour. I'm now going to play 3 innings of an MLB The Show game. I'm unfortunately not connected to the internet. For some reason, it won't connect to the internet. So I don't know if this is like, if I start playing the game, is it going to save? I honestly have no clue because I'm not on Wi-Fi. But game 2, ALCS, this is about how loud I'm going to talk. Not talk very loud at all. Robin Roberts pitching for the Twins. I got my ace, Randy Johnson, pitching. 3 innings? I'm going to move back to the bed till 10. Mike Schmidt brings in 2 runners with runners on first and second. Double into the gap, and the Mariners up 2-0. I've had runners on first and second both innings. Stranded them the first inning, not this time. Mike Schmidt comes up huge. Mark McGwire, the very next batter, crushes it to left field. 384 feet, his second homer on the postseason. It's 4-0 Mariners. He's taking the spot of Larry Walker in that 9-hole spot. It's either him or Mark McGwire. Larry Walker's been good, but I put Mark McGwire in, and he hits a homer. It's 4-0 Mariners. Jonas Wagner stole second, and Harmon Killebrew base hit center field. Easily scores Jonas Wagner. Mariners have 5 runs this inning. It's 5-0 Mariners.
All right, it's 9:30. Just played 4 innings of the MLB game. It's still 5-0, but turned it back to the Thundermans. Gonna sit here for 30 more minutes, and then at 10 o'clock. Move to the other bedroom.
Right, it's 10:06, just moved to the bedroom. Still watching the Thundermans. Gonna sit here till 10:45. I'll go back to my room.
All right, it's 10:36, just moved back to my room. Still watching the Thundermans. I could watch Sonic, it's on channel 170. I watched it yesterday though, so I don't need to.
Gonna sit here for about 15, 20 minutes and then I'm going to play 3 more innings of my MLB game.
All right, 11 o'clock, I just got word. We might be headed to Glacier Park. I'm not completely sure. Been watching the Thundermans for a long, long time, but I'm now gonna play, honestly, I could probably just play the rest of my MLB game at this rate. I think that's what I'm gonna do, rest of the MLB game, and then figure out what to do after that.
Mariners haven't scored since the second inning. Madison Bumgarner has shut down the Mariners, but finally, the first home run of the game, it's Roberto Clemente to left field, his second on the year. It was 411 feet. And the Mariners finally add another. It's 6-0. And that does it. The Mariners win 6-0. Randy Johnson gives up only 3 hits. He strikes out 12. A complete game shutout. ERA is now at 1 with a 2-0 record. Mariners only had 9 hits, only scored 6 runs. They beat the Twins. They shut them out 6-0. Mariners win. Since it's 11:30, I'm going to play 3 more innings in my next game. And then at 12 o'clock, I just found out that's the official time I'm going to Glacier Park. So 12 o'clock. Joe Morgan's speed helps the Mariners get run number 1. Had a single into center field, then stole second, stole third. I mean, that's the first time anybody's ever stole third. Ground out to second, scores a run, 1-0 Mariners. Mike Piazza hit a leadoff single. For the 3rd inning in a row, the leadoff batter reached. Ricky Henderson then crushed a double off the wall. That allowed Mike Piazza to score to make it 2-0. Unfortunately, Ricky Henderson got thrown out at second base, so there is 2 outs for the Mariners. Once again, tack on another, it's 2-0. Joe Morgan is a stolen base machine today. Once again, singles to lead off the inning. 4 straight innings with the leadoff hit, then stole second, stole third, runners on the corners, 1 out. Single up the middle, scores Joe Morgan. Mike Schmidt moves up to second, runners on first and second. 1 out, Mariners lead 3-0. The hits just keep on coming, runners on first and second. Mike Piazza, single up the middle, brings home another run, and it's 4-0 Mariners. Sacrifice fly, Jonas Wagner gives the Mariners another run. It is now 5-0 Mariners.
All right, it's 11:56, just got done playing 4 innings. Mike Trout hit a 2-run homer, 5-2. Since I'm leaving in 4 minutes, I'm gonna end the vlog here for now. I don't know when I'll pick it back up. I'll write down what time I leave, what songs I listen to.
But right now, time to head to Glacier Park.
All right, everybody, it's the next day. This is Monday. What the plan for these vlogs is going to be is whenever I'm not able to vlog anything, I will write my stuff down on my phone just like I did the opening day and then update you the next day, but this will go in the vlog on Sunday. So I don't remember exactly what I was talking about yesterday. I'm pretty sure I played an MLB game. So the last clip should have been like, all right, I'm going to Glacier Park now. Just finished my MLB game. I'll update you when I get back. That should have been the last clip. Now, when I got back, I took a shower and then went to my mom's room. So that's the next clip after this clip. This is going to be in between. This is going to be basically everything that I just said I was going to do in Glacier Park that I could not vlog. All right. I got the iPad here with all the stuff on it. So let's get right into it. Yesterday. I left at 12:13. I don't remember what time exactly I said I was going to leave, but I ended up leaving here at 12:13. And then at 12:16, 3 minutes later, I stopped at Town Pump. I got beef jerky, a Pepsi, and what else did I get? I guess I wrote it down. And Cheeto Puffs. I was going to get potato skins. They were out. And I was also going to get Pringles. They were out of that as well. So I had to settle for Cheeto Puffs. They were out of a lot of stuff, surprisingly. So I had to settle with that. Then at 12:25... left Eureka. The music was incredible yesterday. I'm going to put that on the screen right now. I mean, the songs I listened to yesterday. I mean, I listened to Wake Me Up by Avicii. Avicii Levels, Good Feeling came on. What else song came on? I know there was a Let It Go came on. I mean, the music was on another level. And I wish I could have vlogged that. If I was by myself, obviously I would have. But two of my top five favorite songs in Avicii Levels and Wake Me Up. So that was awesome. Again, put the list on the screen. And then at 1:16, I stopped at McDonald's and Whitefish. I ended up getting a cheeseburger with a high C orange, french fries, my normal thing. I was going to get spicy chicken nuggets, but they were out for some reason. I don't know why. And then immediately after going to McDonald's, we went through the drive-thru. We went through the Starbucks drive-thru at 1:25. I got a cake pop, and then we were off and running. And then at 2:03, we actually entered Glacier Park. So we went through the Glacier Park gates at 2:03. And then we just went to Apgar, went to down to the lake, went into the cedar tree, went to Eddie's, all that stuff. And then we left Apgar an hour later at 3:02. So we were there an hour. And then at 3:28, we left Glacier Park. I'm trying to think what took so long to leave Glacier Park. Oh, yeah. On the way back, we drove through the golf course. And then we also stopped at the other gift shop there as well. And then left Glacier Park. And then at 3:32, we ended up driving through the KOA just to see what it looked like, you know. Left that. 3:48, we stopped at the Senex in Hungry Horse. There, I finally got my Pringles. I got two flavored waters. I got a Sunrise Peach or whatever it's called. Peach and Huckleberry Montana Treasure Water. So that was good. At 4:04, stopped at Dairy Queen in Columbia Falls. Got chocolate ice cream. Had a weird texture. Didn't really taste the same, but it was still all right. Dollar on the wheel. Dollar on the wheel. Much of the price is right, by the way. You'll see that in tomorrow's vlog. And then at 4:17, we got into Whitefish. And instead of just going right back to Eureka, we ended up going up to Big Mountain for a while. I didn't say anything like when I got to Big Mountain or whatnot. But 5:46 is when I ended up getting back at 5:46. And then at 5:52, immediately after, I took a shower. Wait, no, I came in here. Never mind. I thought I got back later than I did. I'm pretty sure I came in here and started editing a vlog. I don't know. You'll see in the next clip. The next clip, if I did this right, should be me sitting in my bed at 5:52 right after I took a shower. That's what it should be, around 6 o'clock. So there's your update on what I did in Glacier Park. I, of course, could not update you on that. But let's get back to the regular scheduled vlog. 6 o'clock, me sitting on the bed. And continue with the night.
All right, it's 6:11. Got back at around 5:45. Just got out of the shower, watching the Nuggets game. Minnesota's up 13-9. The plan is now going to be to sit here for 50 minutes till 7 o'clock. I'm going to edit the next vlog, and then at 7 o'clock, I'll make popcorn. I'll move into the bedroom. There's a fly in here that is driving me absolutely crazy. It will not stop going everywhere. It's going to drive me crazy all night long. 50 minutes editing the vlog. That's what I'm going to be doing. Watch the Nuggets game. All right, it's 6:33 Denver. After losing two games at home, they won game 3 on the road. And now they're winning game 4 after one Nikola Jokic at the buzzer to end the first quarter. Nuggets up 5, 29, 24. Denver's on a 26-4 run, and they all of a sudden lead by 15. Where in the world did this come from? Denver's starting to show why they're the defending champions. They look really good once again here on the road. It's 7:04. I just moved to the bedroom. What a turn of events. It was a single-digit lead for Denver. Minnesota came back. 8-0 run for the Denver Nuggets. This is crazy. Timberwolves turned the ball over. It was a 10-point game. Timberwolves turned the ball over. Right here. And then Porter slams it. 11-point game. Then there's only 2 seconds left. They inbound the ball. Murray steals it and then shoots a half-court shot that switches it in. And it's a 15-point lead for the Denver Nuggets. What a turnaround.
That was absolutely crazy in terms of momentum. A 5-point swing. Wow, but as I was just going to say, at 7 o'clock, moved to the bedroom. Got my popcorn. Been editing the vlog for the past hour. I'm done with 20 minutes of it. It's a 47-minute vlog, so for the next hour, I'm going to keep doing that. I'm going to do it all night long until I get done. Got my drinks. Got my snacks. 5-point run for the Denver Nuggets. That's 8-0 run in 15 seconds. Denver has been up all game long. Timberwolves got it down to single digits. And an 8-0 run in 15 seconds, and just like that, Denver's back up by 15. What an ending to that half.
All right, it's 7:07. I just turned it to Jurassic World Dominion. This is on channel 352. This is a channel I didn't even have on Spectrum. So I wouldn't even be able to watch this if I was in Missoula. Fun fact, that guy right there who's on the screen, not him. The other guy, he was on the Thundermans in the earlier episode about the rat race, where Billy's turned into a rat. I mean, that's crazy. What I'm going to do now is watch this for about 15 minutes, and then the second half of the Timberwolves game will start. Turn that game back on. We're at 7:26. Just turned it back to the Nuggets game. I missed the first 2 minutes of the second half, but that's all right. Denver, as you saw, 7 straight field goals. Make it 8. Denver's back up 15.
We're at 7:39. I've just been editing the vlog. I mean, basically ever since 6 o'clock when I got out of the shower. I'm done editing 30 minutes of it, 44 minutes, so 14 more minutes to go. But right now, I'm going to take a break, watch the end of the Timberwolves game. It's 7:40, so I'll probably start editing the rest of the vlog at 9. I mean, 14 minutes should take about 30 to 45 more minutes to edit. But right now, I'm going to watch the Minnesota Timberwolves game. Minnesota is still losing, but they are sort of making a comeback. Almost the end of the third quarter, so I'll pick the vlog back up, of course, when that happens.
It's 7:47, Denver up 90-79. There's a steal. Full court shot almost. Anthony Edwards has 37 points through three quarters. It is a 6-0 run for Minnesota, but they are still down by 11. Denver, one quarter away from tying this series up. So far, the home team has yet to win a game, which is just baffling after the way these playoffs started.
All right, it's 8:03, still watching the Nuggets game. Nuggets up 101-88. 8 minutes to go. It looks like the Nuggets are going to win this game. And if the Nuggets do win this game, I think the Nuggets have figured out the Timberwolves. And I think the Nuggets are going to win this series. If this was the Lakers, I'd be incredibly scared right now. The Lakers would blow it. But this is not the Lakers. The defending champs starting to play like it.
It's 105-97. This is the closest it has been in the second half. Minnesota, you're going to make a comeback. You better do it now.
It's 8:29. That's going to do it. The Denver Nuggets win 115-107.
No one can win at home for some reason. Denver loses 2 games at home. Minnesota loses 2 games at home. So how about this? Road team has won each game in this series. Next game is Tuesday at 8:30. I think Denver's going to win this series. Anthony Edwards had 44 points. Didn't matter. Lost the game. I could watch the Canucks-Oilers game. Or I could watch the end of Jurassic World Dominion. I think what I'm going to do now that that game's over, I'm going to watch, where is it? Where is it? There it is. I'm going to watch Jurassic World Dominion until 9:05. All right, it's 8:52. Jurassic World is just ending. I don't know how because it says it goes on until 9:05, but just ended. What to watch? What to watch? You know what? Let's watch the Canucks-Oilers game, just like last night. I'm going to start editing the vlog again. Finish it off at 9:40. I'll go into my room for the night. But until then, for 47 minutes... and watch the Canucks-Oilers game.
All right, it's 10:05. I've just been sitting in my room for the past 25 minutes. Just got done listening to the music channel. Turned it to the news. 10:05. What the plan is going to be tonight is for 30 minutes, I'm going to sit here watching the news. That's what I'm watching right now, is the news.
And then at 10:35, I'm going to turn on the recording of Fallon. That way I'm watching it at the same time. Going to watch all the commercials just like it's a real show. That's how I'm going to treat it. Over the last hour, I was editing. You know what? I could very well... I'm not going to watch the hockey game. I'll probably flip back and forth between this and the hockey game. I ended up getting done with the vlog around 9:30. It was 40 minutes long, so I'm now going to get that into my camera roll. Get that onto YouTube. Delete all the clips. That's what I'm going to be doing. I might be flipping back and forth between the news and the hockey game. There's only 8 minutes left. Okay, so here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to watch the hockey game till it's over, and if there's any time left before 10:35, I'm going to turn the news back on, and I'll turn Fallon on 10:35.
10:21, Edmonton has been losing 4-2 this entire game. Look at this. It bounced off the post. There was nobody there. If that went in, this game would be over. Instead, Edmonton scores a goal. It's now 4-3. They're down. There's a minute left. Unlikely that they're going to win this game, but they still got a chance.
5-4-3. They got to shoot it.
Wide of the net. That's game. Vancouver wins it. 4-3. And we got some fighting. Of course we do. 41 saves for Vancouver.
All right, I see it down there. Jimmy Fallon. Why I was so interested in watching this. He's got John Krasinski, who, of course, is Jim in The Office, which is awesome. Brooke Shields, she made an appearance on Impractical Jokers. And Tracy Sierra was the winning author of the Jimmy Fallon Book Club, so that's pretty cool. Gonna watch this now.
Here comes Jimmy with his guitar again. Love it when he does these songs. You already know I'm not forgetting about this. Tuesday, May 14th, the 10th anniversary special. Of course I'm watching that. Oh yeah, Tracy Sierra, I'm excited to see all these guests. This is one of the best lineups Fallon's ever had. John Krasinski, Brooke Shields, Tracy Sierra, that's epic. I was going to say, I forgot Brooke Shields is in Mother of the Bride. Miranda Cosgrove is in that as well. Maybe she'll talk about that, who knows. Here comes John Krasinski. There's Jim from The Office. He's talking about the new movie, if that's coming out, that he produced, basically. Might have to watch that. Sounds interesting. Jim Halpert from The Office. There he is. And I want to watch this If movie now. That sounds actually really good. Especially if John Krasinski directed it. Brooke Shields looks the same as she did on Impractical Jokers. I like this. I can fast forward the commercials now. I've never been so excited for a guest I have never seen before. Tracy Sierra. Night watching. I think it's so awesome that Fallon decided to bring her on the show. That's why he's the best. Best in the business. There she is. Winner. I have never seen what she looks like. No joke. She's on Fallon. Gotta love it, man. They're gonna make a movie out of this book?
This lady's living the dream. Who would have imagined? You start writing a book and it gets you on Fallon and a movie? That's epic, man. All right, 10:56, that's going to do it for Fallon. I really enjoyed that episode of Fallon from John Krasinski. Brooke Shields was awesome. And of course, Tracy Sierra, that was a great cast. Turned it to SportsCenter, that's going to do it for this vlog. Probably going to watch SportsCenter for about, 25 more minutes, then I'll shut the TV off and call it a night. No more staying up till midnight and 1 a.m. now that I'm at my parents' house. It is what it is. I mean, you can see that it's a different vibe in here. It's much darker. Hopefully you enjoyed this vlog. I will see you tomorrow.